Yeah, mate, I think this might be a really good time to start pulling some samples out.
Getting them in the pan.
Yeah, that sounds good, mate.
The Gold Retrievers, Brad McGee and Chris Smith, are desperately looking for ways to improve the gold yield on their 2 square kilometre Devil's Cut lease.
Yeah, we'll start taking a few samples. I mean, we've found good gold nuggets in here, so let's see if there's some fine gold as well, mate. We might be on the mother lode.
The investment that we've put in towards the operation here has been around $250,000. That's a lot of money for a first-timer to put in.
Our families are relying on us to make this work. It's hard being away from the family, but if you have to put the time and effort in, then that's what you got to do. So this week we've got a dry blower turning up, hopefully, fingers crossed, which is going to change the whole game for us, really. It gives us just another option. We've still got about 27 ounces to go, so hopefully we find a few more nuggets, but we believe there's a lot of fine gold through everything we've been digging out, so this will prove it.
This is sort of a bit of a do-or-die moment.
Sure is. Let's give her a burl.
Give it a go, mate.
We've just dropped another 35K into the dry blower, so that's it's another debt that we really didn't want.
Be nice to just get one little speck, then we can concentrate on where that came from.
If there's anything in the pan, we should be able to see it very shortly. Come on, baby. Is that a bit of gold?
Holy dooly. That's a nice little piece.
Yes.
Oh,
that's
baby.
Unreal. If that's all through that stuff, dry blower's going to pick that up, mate. We're going to do very well.
Russell builds great dry blowers, so we've got a lot of confidence in him.
How are you, mate?
Good to see you.
Local bush mechanic Russell Higgins has custom built a $35,000 dry blower for the pair, capable of pumping through 10 tonnes of pay dirt an hour. The unique design has no moving parts, making it tough enough to withstand the harsh outback conditions.
I think we call it dusty.
It's gonna be
the last piece of the puzzle. The dry blower has no moving parts, so there's no breakdowns that we can foresee. It's pretty much a fail-safe piece of machinery. If that doesn't produce, it's another waste of money.
If you've got any mush in the dirt at all, don't run it. You'll end up with problem after problem of blockages, and that will happen with any dry blower as well.
Yep. We'll send you a photo of the first yield of gold, mate.
Very nice.
Hey, Brad! Hey!
What?
Get up!
Oh,
come on.
What's going on?
Can't you hear that? Yeah.
Let's go, man.
Righto.
An unexpected storm has blown in overnight, putting the Gold Retriever's brand new dry blower out of action.
It didn't say it was going to rain today.
Well, I don't know.
It was coming tonight.
The dry blower's sitting in the rain, so we've got to try and cover it up as quick as we can. We just can't get it wet, otherwise it's just useless to us.
Grab the rope, mate. I'll just start dragging this tarp over.
Yeah, hang on, mate. I've got
the ladder.
No, we're good.
We've got to get
Don't
this cover
tear
up,
it, mate. Don't tear it.
I'm hoping we haven't got any moisture down the chutes, because that's days of drying out once we get sunshine back.
Yeah, this is serious. I mean, this is a serious bit of gear, you know. You've got all the electrics, things like that. Any moisture on this machine could potentially ruin it, and you're pretty much throwing money out the window. We potentially made a massive mistake here. We're going to try and find gold, no matter what the weather conditions, so we're going to try and make something work. Hey!
Hey!
Whoa!
Right there? You're going to get back up or what?
I don't know. I didn't realise it was that slippery, eh?
Chris scrapes 15 centimetres off the surface layer, allowing their detectors to penetrate deeper in search of nuggets.
Just take it easy getting back up there, eh?
Yeah, mate.
Yeah, it's not going to work, Brad. Bring it down, mate.
We're up here to find gold. That's what our families are expecting of us. We just can't sit around, wait for the rain to stop. All right, let's have a go, mate. Let's not rule out yet.
If anyone can do it, you can, mate.
Ah, well, I'll give it a go.
back it down, mate. You're just destroying it.
I literally have put my life savings into this. We have to start paying the money back into our accounts.
Just gonna destroy it, Brad.
She's not going, mate. Our dry blowing stuff, our push and detecting stuff. I don't know what else. We don't have any other options, mate. I don't know what to do. I think the only way I'm going to get you out of that pit at the moment is by using excavator bucket. Just try and grab your bucket and help you out a little bit, you know?
If that doesn't, nothing will.
Righto, mate, here we go.
Yeah, up you go, mate.
We've got to be very careful. If we damage either one of those machines, that's just more cost on top of everything.
Easy does it.
Back in business, boy!
Out of the swimming pool!
Clock's ticking, mate. Let's get it going, eh?
At the moment, we've got a very small window in the weather, I think. You can actually see the black clouds coming through again now, so we need to be as quick as we possibly can. We need to get this ramp back up and working, because if we can't get the loader in there, we can't push, we can't find nuggets.
Brad reinforces the ramp with dry dirt, allowing Chris to enter safely with the loader.
So what Chris can do now is he can take off another 6 inches and then we can start detecting again. So hopefully we take out a whole new layer and we're into fresh ground again.
Ah, that's better. That's better.
How's it looking?
Looking good, mate.
Good?
Looking good.
Beautiful. Looks good to me, mate.
I'll just park her up the end here and we'll start on that end. I'll grab the detector.
Sounds like a plan, mate. Yep. No worries.
Good luck, mate.
Thanks, mate. Good luck to you too.
Cheers, bud.
We're looking for that crisp sound coming through the detector. Hey, now that's a target.
That's a target. That's a definite target, mate. This weather's coming in, it's coming in fast, so try and sort of work together and try and get something on the board, you know. Where do you think, mate?
I reckon he's...
That is, mate. That's pretty hard ground.
That's never been worked before.
Ah, that's hard as... hard as, mate.
Oh.
Look at that.
Dude.
Just saw it.
Woo. That's a beautiful piece of gold, mate. I'd say $3,000 easy, mate.
Yep. So, a couple hundred bucks.
Yeah,
yeah. Well done, mate.
I'd go over it again, just make sure that's the only one in
absolutely
there.
Absolutely. No, that's a little beautiful ripper, that piece. One.
Mate, that's
another target.
I think we'll try the scoop on him, eh?
Yeah.
If it's on top, it's another piece. Hold on to that piece of gold. I don't want to lose
all
it.
All right, this is either another piece in the same pocket.
What's that?
Straight away.
That. Another piece.
Well done.
That's great. Absolutely fantastic.
That's his brother.
A couple of pieces for the board. Finding a couple of nuggets in quick succession gives us high hopes that we're going to do quite well. Let's go and have a weigh up, eh?
Oh, geez, it's been a long week, eh?
It has been a long week, mate, and a filthy one at that.
550 kilometres southeast, the gold retrievers have had their operation crippled by torrential rain, but they still need an ounce of gold this week to stay afloat.
Not really on track yet, but it's been a couple of good little finds. We're not sitting on our laurels, are we?
Let's check it, eh?
Yep.
Let's see what we got.
1.3,
there you go, we're right in the middle.
That's awesome.
There you go, I'm happy with that.
I'm very happy with that.
Yeah, look, I mean, this is a bonus. I didn't think we were going to come out of it with anything.
The 1.3 ounce, $3,000 payday not only covers their weekly costs, but delivers a much needed profit to their bottom line.
I'll put this away and now.
Put him in a safe place, mate.
We'll get into it.
Yeah. We're going to be putting that dry blower through its paces.